Namaste. The next problem in the departmental accounts. The following trial balance for the year ended 31st March 2015 has been extracted from the books of Sapna departmental stores. Here they have given opening capital, drawings. So where it is being used? Opening capital, it is being used in the balance sheet. Okay, same drawings, then stock. So stock is used, opening stock, that you know, it is in the trading account. Then sales in the trading account, purchases, it is used in the trading account of two departments they have given. Then salaries, profit and loss account, publicity expenses, again profit and loss account. Then rent, rates and taxes, profit and loss account. Commission, profit and loss account. So all these things, profit and loss account. Miscellaneous expenses, profit and loss account. Furniture and fixtures, so furniture and fixtures, this is in the balance sheet. Okay, furniture and fixtures because it is an asset. Okay, let me mark it in red, balance sheet items. Then debtors and creditors, balance sheet. 4% government bonds, this is investment asset, balance sheet. Interest on government bonds, it is interest, that is revenue, it is in the profit and loss account. Provision for doubtful debts, gain, profit and loss account. Cash at bank, so usually it is written in the balance sheet. Prepare departmental trading in profit and loss account, they asked, and balance sheet. So first thing we should understand which one we have to prepare, trading in profit and loss account and balance sheet. See here they have given stock on 31st March 2015. So this is the closing stock. So closing stock will be appeared in the balance sheet. And trading account. Correct? There are two entries in the adjustment. Then the amount of 1200 out of debtors has to be written off as bad. So there is bad debt. And the provision for doubtful debts has to be increased thereafter to 10% of the debtors. So there is bad debt as well as reserve for bad debts. So this will appear in two sides, which are those profit and loss account and balance sheet. Then the following expenses are outstanding. So outstanding expenses, same thing here, whatever is given, profit and loss account and balance sheet, all the three. Provide 10% depreciation on furniture and fixtures, same thing, profit and loss account and balance sheet. All the revenue items to be allocated in the ratio of 2:1 as between the two departments. So this is very important point. So whatever revenue items are there, that should be divided among the two departments, 2:1 ratio. Let us prepare trading and profit and loss account, departmental trading and profit and loss account. Usually this is same as your trading and profit and loss account, but different departments you have to show here. See here, radio department, watches, and total, an extra column, total. This is simple. Once you prepare everything, you can make the total and you can cross verify whether you made any mistakes, you'll come to know. So this is the extra column, right? So the first thing, two opening stock given in the problem, purchases, sales, closing stock. You know the format of trading account, right? So opening stock, purchases, if there are any direct expenses we have to write, then sales and closing stock. We have written all these, and total, make the total of both the sides. 3,24,000, 3,24,000. In a sense, balancing figure will be the gross profit. So this you have to find out. Gross profit. For watches, gross profit is 34,000. Then gross profit brought down. Same thing you are writing. Then you have to write all the expenses, revenue expenses that I discussed. So salaries. In the case of salaries, it is given here 12,600. but in the adjustment they have also given outstanding on 31st March 2015, that is the outstanding salary at the end of the year, so 1200, correct? So what we are supposed to do? So salary 12600 and outstanding salary 1200, correct? So total will be 13800. So they said you have to distribute the expenses, revenue expenses, in 2:1 ratio. So 2:1, 2:1 ratio, that means what? 2 by 3 1 by 3. See here, the total salary including outstanding salary 13800 into 2 by 3, 9200, 13800 into 1 by 3, 4600. So same thing here, two salaries along with the outstanding salary. So 9200, 4600. Then same thing, all the expenses, publicity expenses along with the outstanding expenses. You have to add and 2:1. So both rent, rates and taxes, distribute 2:1. Commission, there is outstanding commission. So whenever expenses are outstanding, we have to add it. So 10,600 plus outstanding. So on that answer, 2 by 3, 1 by 3, you have to distribute. Then miscellaneous expenses, same thing, 2:1. Bad debts, here you see bad debt in the problem, which is given as 1200 in the adjustment. It is clearly given an amount of 1200 out of debtors is considered as bad. So 1200, and there should be 10% reserve provision, right? Provision. So how to do it? What is the debtors amount? Debtors always show debit balance, because debtors are the assets. Assets always show debit balance in the trial balance. So debtors 16,800. Okay, so bad debt 1200 it is given. Then RBD we have to find out, provision. So 10% on good debtors. So that means the net debtors we have to take. 16,800, which is given in the trial balance, minus 1200 bad debts. So the net good debtors you get only 15,600 on that 10%, 1560. Clear? So see, bad debts 1200, add new RBD minus old RBD. So 800 is given in the trial balance provision for bad debts. So this we have to deduct. Okay, this is newly created, so we are adding. This is given in the trial balance, so we are deducting it. Clear? Whatever answer it comes, so you have to divide it. 2:1 ratio. Then depreciation on furniture. So they have given, provide 10% depreciation on furniture. So what is the furniture value? Furniture 12,400, correct? Okay, depreciation 12,400 into 10 by 100, 10%, 1240. This 1240 should be divided. What is the ratio? 2 by 3. Sorry, this is 1 by 3. It should be 2 by 3 and 1 by 3. Okay, so we are dividing depreciation, correct? And interest on bonds they have given. So that is an that is a revenue for us, income. So it should be written on the credit side. Clear? So total both the sides, okay, total both the sides, and the balancing figure will be the net profit, and this should be transferred to your balance sheet. Now consolidated balance sheet you have to write. So capital given in the problem, add net profit less drawings. So you know the format. What is the format? Capital, add interest on capital, add net profit, less drawings, less interest on drawings. So this is always the same thing. So creditors given in the problem, liability. Then outstanding expenses, all the three. So outstanding expenses are a liability we are writing here. Here furniture and fixtures, less depreciation. Debtors, less bad debt, less RBD. Okay, this we are writing. 4% government bonds, because it is an asset, cash at bank, closing stock. So the balance sheet gets tallied. Okay, that's it.